Hey guys, Aggressive here, and welcome back to Mass Effect 3. So in the last episode, we've been on Mene, the moon of Palavan, and we picked up a Garrus, and we picked up Primarch Victus. So we are all ready to basically go and have the summit with the Salarians and the Krogan, and the Turians as well. But before we do that, the way things happen in Mass Effect 3 basically is that when the side missions come up, you're best off sort of doing those first. And then doing the story-based missions, the sort of priority missions, funnily enough, not doing the priority missions first. Doing them after all the other side missions. Because otherwise the story generally moves on and you lose access to some of the areas and some of the other missions. And then you can't complete them. So, what we're going to do is we're going to go do the Cerberus Lab mission up here first. And then what I think we might do is we either might go to the Citadel and do all that stuff, because we need to go back to the Citadel and need to talk to a bunch of people, and the Citadel should be all opened up by now, so we can go to all the other areas. And that's going to be like almost, I want to say, an episode on itself, because I want to keep these episodes down... down in size a little bit, because up until now they've been like a couple of hour long ones and they're not the best, so I'm going to try and make them at least half an hour, 45 minutes, something like that. I was going to go just however long they needed to go, but an hour's kind of taking the mick a little bit, so I'm going to try and cut this down. So yeah, we need to go to Citadel, but that's going to be like a whole episode on its own, I think, and then we should go do the Recover Protein Artifact mission, which is actually the From Ashes DLC. And then we've got to rescue the students, and then we've got to go and do the actual main story mission. So let's go to the N7 lab mission and get that done, and then we'll worry about the rest of the stuff in a minute. So here we are in Skepsis. I'm going to go up here to Decorus, where the Cerberus lab mission is. So things are a little bit different on the galaxy map with this scan impulse, like we mentioned in the previous episode. And what you're going to do is, you know, fly around the
I found something.
System doing that, and not doing it too much so that the Reapers come and get you. Now, we haven't, usually there's a bar around here somewhere where the actually says how much the Reapers are detecting you or whether they're coming to get you or not. And luckily, we don't have that in this system at the moment. And it's probably because of this mission. Sometimes there's some safe systems, so you don't have to worry about it. But yeah, most of the systems, you actually have to watch out how much you use that scan impulse, and then if the Reapers come after you, you actually have to go do a mission or go do something else and then come back to it. And this is the mining. This is the extent, right, of the mining mini game. Is that you literally just do it once or twice to pick up like things which are on planets, but you never have to do it to actually mine resources like in ME2, which is a welcome change, to be honest. Because that was, I don't know, I didn't mind it, but it was a little bit boring after like the third or fourth or fifth or sixth time you had to do it. It got a little bit boring, but it wasn't too bad. You should have the nice galaxy map music to do that. So here we are at Sanctum. Let's land here and take out this Cerberus lab. So I think we should take Liara, and I'm going to take Garrus. I actually want to take Edie, but this type of mission, I want Liara's singularity. That'll come in quite useful. So all my guns are all cool, all Liara's guns are all fine, and so Garrus is. Although he could do with the other mod. There you go, the extra ammo. And I've got 5 points, so I'm going to save up so I can get my fitness all the way up. Garrus has 4, so I'm going to put it on his armor-piercing ammo. And Liara has 4 as well, so I'm going to put that on her warp ammo. And even goes just the 1. Okay. So here we go.
Commander, I've got a hail from Admiral Hackett.
Put him through, Lieutenant.
Shepard, we've uncovered a secret Cerberus lab, function unknown. We sent in a recon team, but they were forced to pull out before they got very far.
Any other intel?
We think they're using the facility to warehouse and study Reaper tech. We've been wondering how Cerberus is connected to the Reapers, and this might give us some answers.
We're on it.
what Cerberus is doing and get me any Reaper tech samples you can, Commander. Hack it out.
So the weird thing about these N7 missions is that they've got a bit more of a story in them, in the fact that they sort of support the main story a bit more. But they're all on the multiplayer maps, like the core unchanged multiplayer maps, which is kind of weird to go back and see them again.
On my way.
Okay, I just want to move around my powers a little bit, because that was kind of throwing me a little bit last mission. So I'm just going to do that, and want their warp ammo on and Garrus's armor piercing ammo on, so let's do that. And right, let me just move around these powers, and then we'll get on with the mission. Okay, let's see how we get on with that. That's the one thing about coming from the Xbox to the PC that I still haven't quite got used to, is having all the powers on the numbers along the top. I suppose I could rebind the keys, actually. But yeah, on the Xbox, you get really used to having two powers at, like, really close to your fingertips. And granted, you have got that with the PC version as well. Right, what we got here? We got a personal log. Finally here. Wow, the troops here are really intense. No one smiles ever. And suicide on order. Suicide on capture orders. Seriously? They call training integration. I start being integrated tomorrow. Can't wait. Okay, that's a little bit creepy. So what was this talking about? Oh yes, the powers, the key bindings. Yeah, it's you get real used to having all these powers at your fingertips, like up to 8 of them at the same time, and then you realize that, you know, it's all the way along the top of the keyboard, and it's actually there's nothing to pick up here now. It's actually kind of weird to stretch your hand all the way across to get to number 8 for whatever. There we go, that's what I wanted. That's what I wanted. Oh, you and your grenades, man. You and your grenades. Jeez. Did we get everyone? Cool, we got everyone. We've got credits around here to pick up, and we've got credits everywhere. Oh, and a mod. Lovely. Just want to make sure I picked up all those credits. Journal entry, integration successful. Suicide on capture orders confirmed. Cerberus is my friend. Obey, protect humanity at any cost. Credits. That's actually what we've got to pick up, isn't it? Yeah, okay. There is just one more thing to pick up, if I can remember where it is. Oh yeah, it's in this little room. I always forget about this little room now, because in multiplayer this is all blocked off, so you can't actually go in here.
Huh. Will only lead to metagel advances for Hanar. Only Cerberus would call that a failure.
Okay, let's pick this thing up.
It appears to be Reaper tech, but the signature is new to me.
Got the sample.
Roger that. Meet you at the landing pad. Second sample located, Commander. Nav point updated.
Good work.
Right, we got, oh boy, we got turrets, we got everything here, we got everything. Let's get Liara's singularity there.
Good work.
I don't even know who was shooting me there. I was in a... I was in cover. Okay, I'm gonna go around. Oh yeah, I don't like fighting down there anyway, it's a little bit too awkward. Turrets everywhere. Oh great, you can't shoot me from here. This is awesome. Engineers, man. I hate them. They're so annoying. Another one. I can't quite hit it with the overload there because it's behind the cover. Once again, it can't shoot me because of that. That's awesome. Okay, are we all done here? Are we all done? I knew I was gonna die during these playthroughs, because, you know, it's insanity. And hopefully that's not too bad to watch. Or too boring to watch, rather. I guess that's up to me, isn't it?
Must be Reaper tech. My brain hurts just looking at it.
Cortez, second sample secured. Heading back to you now.
Negative, Commander. Head got hot. Has to bug out. Got three birds on my six. Taking fire. Scratch that. Make it four. We'll rendezvous when I can. Out.
We just need to hold out until Cortez can pick us up.
Nothing like being stranded.
Never said it would be easy.
Oh, guys, come on. I ain't coming to you. You need to come to me. This is insanity. Gotcha. Oh shit. There's nowhere to run in there as well. Ah. Yeah, I guess I didn't think about that, did I? Don't make me come after you.
Over
yet. I'm with you. Oh, that was a mistake. That's me getting all brave. Yeah, there we go.
What's your status?
Engaging multiple targets. Time for something a bit risky.
Lieutenant!
shit!
There goes the easy route.
Just reload and keep fighting!
Get down!
Oh, come on. No, don't. Ah, jeez. Let's try that again, shall we? Well, at least the checkpoints aren't terrible. Oh, so close that time as well. So close. Grenades. I'm gonna take your grenades and I'm gonna shove them down you. Don't let the pink armor fool you. Oh man, I missed a grab. I missed a grab. You gotta be kidding me. Guardians, you're a joke. You're a joke. The Guardians are just the joke class of Mass Effect 3. Missed it again. I'm definitely upgrading this gun as soon as I can.
Cortez, do you copy?
I don't think he made it.
He'll make it. Let's just keep the landing pad clear.
Centurions are the assholes of the Cerberus classes. I mean, you know, as long as you don't count Phantoms. With their shields and their backpacks. Oh, nice one, the aura. Oh, bugger. Ah, oh, shit. Shit. Oh, crap.
Extraction as soon as you can get here.
Enjoy. There you go.
We're at the
Chase, where are you guys all coming from? How did you even see that? How did he even roll out the way? How did he see that? Alright, they are totally swarming us. And this is turning into a kind of a clusterfuck. So let's get in there. There we go. Oh wow, mission over. God, that was supposed to be just a short mission as well.
Commander, we've we've got our best engineers looking at the Reaper tech you secured from that lab.
What was Cerberus doing with it?
We don't know yet, but whatever Cerberus is up to, it can't be good. Even if we can't determine its purpose, we've disrupted their experiments.
I doubt they'll just close up shop.
Agreed. We'll keep sending strikes against the facility. Good work, Commander.
Okay, cool. Like I said, the N7 missions have a bit more of a story to them, which is kind of cool. And I suppose we get war assets from them. Yeah, Cerberus research data. That's that. I suppose.
Yes, Commander.
He has anything else to say? No, he doesn't.
That's all.
Of course, Commander.
Okay, let's get back to the galaxy map then. Yeah, that was a bit of a meal. I gotta be honest with you. I wasn't expecting that to be that difficult.
Said it out when we were there on leave. You'd never know there was a war on.
You'll know soon enough.
Commander, you may want to check in on shuttle pilot Cortez down in the armory.
Okay.
Commander.
Shuttle pilot Cortez. Okay, let's go sort him out now then. Let's go talk to him now. Meet me on the Citadel. Miranda Lawson. Ah, let's see. This is why it's good that I didn't go immediately to the Citadel, because I knew there's going to be another person to talk to that gets unlocked there. So yeah, there's probably, I know that might be it. Either way, we're going to go do another mission and then go back to the Citadel. I'm not going to put all that in the same episode.
Commander. Sorry, didn't see you there. This is a recording from Ferris Fields. Months ago. I lost a lot of friends that day. I lost my husband. I grieved. Said goodbye, made my peace.
You were talking with him when the collectors hit?
I was organizing construction at a remote station a few clicks south of the main colony. Robert managed to get outside of the field the collectors put up. Instead of running, he called me.
Sorry for your loss. He obviously cared a lot about you.
He was afraid I wouldn't let go. But for him, I moved on. Or at least I thought I had. Then the invasion hits, there's no time. And the one thing I grab is this. I mean, what's the point of moving on with your life when everything is going to hell?
Start thinking that way and we've already lost.
Yeah, you're right, but... Well, to be honest, I've never felt as alone as I do right now.
You're not alone, Steve. I'm here. Anytime you need me.
I appreciate that, Shepard, I really do. But don't worry, Commander. When I'm in that pilot seat, I'm there 100%. I won't fail you. It's just the downtime between missions that's hard, you know?
I know.
I hope I didn't leave you hanging too long on that last Cerberus raid.
I'm just glad we made it out in one piece.
Been a while since I've seen a dogfight like that. Really missed my Trident. ACM isn't really the Kodiak strong suit. Commander? Commander?
Okay, so these sort of chats with your crew and sort of I don't want to call them the Lords missions, but like in Mass Effect 2, you had a message from Kelly, oh, you need to go talk to so-and-so because of XYZ, and it's usually to get you to go do a Lords mission. Obviously, we don't have Lords missions in ME3.
Hey, Commander.
But you do have to go talk to your crew, like, by request, at a few areas. And they actually have things to say, like, in between each mission and stuff as well, so... sometimes they do, sometimes they don't. That's the other weird thing. It seems less programmatic and more sort of more natural in a lot of ways. It's really good. I like it a lot.
You know, in the old days, they didn't have automat on cameras. Reporters had to cake on the makeup.
Still got Engineer Adams there? Yeah, he's still there. So, oh, why am I going in there? I'm not going to go in there to see Thane and I, because he's not here. Dr. Chakras, Karis, they are excellent.
I'm glad to see we have Garrus back. I wanted to help with his scars, but I think he actually likes them.
I have no idea why.
Good to see you, Commander.
A pleasure to see you.
No upgrades, no.
Hello again.
That's the thing, it's not really clear whether you've got anything like specific to say or whether it's just like the random chit chat that you have.
So who needs their ass kicked now?
Okay, anyway, let's get a move on. We'll go back up to the COC. And who we got to talk here? Special Trainer, Primarch Victus, ED Joker.
Commander?
Let's go and talk to ED and Joker, or see if they've got anything to say.
Commander?
How's the ship running, ED?
I am updating the cyber warfare suite around our Reaper IFF. It should resemble Reaper code exactly. Hello, Shepard.
Okay, is that a good thing? I mean, do we want to resemble a Reaper exactly? Alright, so what's next on the list? Let's go to do the From Ashes DLC, the Prothean artifact, because that's good mission. And that is also on the Eden Prime where this all began. So lots of nostalgia coming up, I'm sure. Here we go. We should definitely take Liara and Garrus with us because they're the old crew. Alright guys, so that's it for this episode. In the next episode, we'll go recover the Prothean artifact and do the From Ashes DLC. Thanks for watching guys, I'll see you again next time.